My next guest is a former actress, model, and beauty editor, but her role now is author and mother of two, and she's got some great suggestions for prom safety and some fashion tips as well. Welcome, Erica Katz. She is the author of Bonding Over Beauty. It's funny to talk about prom and safety because it doesn't seem like a very scary, dangerous thing, but why do you talk about it specifically?
Well, what's really scary is not the prom itself, but the after prom, because a lot of kids go to a hotel or they might go to a private house. And what's really scary about that is that if there are drugs and alcohol present and the police come, everybody can be arrested, even if you're not doing anything. So I think that's one of the really scary things about it. Of course, if you end up getting in a car and you've been drinking, we all worry, are they going to drink that night? Are they going to take drugs? What are they going to do? So there's a lot of things parents need to know. And I really encourage parents to get the phone numbers of at least five of their kids' friends, not to call, but just in case of emergency, because you don't want to hover too much, but you still want to have those phone numbers in case something goes wrong.
Because there is this sense that it's supposed to be the night of all nights, and kids probably would do something they wouldn't normally do on a prom night. Is that the assumption?
I think that's what happens. They think this has to be the most important night of my life. Everything great has to happen. It's got to be like that song you heard when you were growing up, or the movies that you see. And really, it's not like that. It's a night to have a great time. It's a night to be with friends, but it's also a night to be safe. And remember, everybody has cameras, so you don't want to do something that's going to end up on YouTube or on Facebook the next day and embarrass you. And of course, I always tell kids, remember, just because you have that great college acceptance letter doesn't mean the college can say, we don't want you. So if you get expelled from school or you get arrested, the college can say no, and then what are you going to do?
Really, they can revoke your acceptance.
Of course they can. Of course, if you get arrested, they have every right to say no. So I tell kids, you know, prom night is not Vegas. You have to be responsible. It's not a night where you should just act in a way that you don't normally act. Yes, have a good time. Yes, go out with your friends. Try to make memories. But also, make sure you're not doing something that's going to jeopardize your future, because it's just not worth it.
You know, as a parent, I hear you say, everyone's got a camera. You can be arrested even if you're just standing in the corner, if bad things are happening in the same room or the next room. And I think, well, why would I let my child go at all? How do you not go too far in telling them they can't do things? And how do you strike that balance?
Well, remember, your child's probably 17 or 18. And if they're going to go to college in 3 months, you've got to let go. And you're not going to say, no, you can't go to the prom. You could say that you have a curfew, because what can you do after 3 a.m. that you can't do before 3 a.m.? I always like to say that. They might not like that so much. But you do have to strike a balance between trusting them and trusting that you've raised them well, because you can't start parenting at 18. Hopefully you've done the work ahead of time. But also talk to them and ask them what their expectations are, whether they think this is going to be the night of all nights. Are they planning to go with their boyfriend? Are they planning to go with friends? What the itinerary is? And then you just have to hope for the best.
Let's talk about the clothing for a little while, because that's a very big deal.
It is.
Especially for girls. But obviously, this is a new day and age, and you know, things can be risque. Or you know, what do you say about that?
Well, there are a lot of schools passing dress codes, which I don't agree with, because it's hard enough to find a dress you can afford that actually looks good on you. So I think the dress code just makes it too limiting. But what I do tell parents is, when you go shopping with your daughter, try to accentuate the part of her body that's the best. So let's say she's heavier on top but has great legs. So maybe she wears a shorter dress, but she's a little more covered up. If her upper body is the best part of her, then maybe you wear a strapless and you wear a longer dress. But what I think is the wrong thing is when everything's showing, the back, the up here, and then your legs. I think you just sort of have to pick and choose. But again, you know, if you dress sexy all the time, you're probably going to dress sexy to the prom. I don't think somebody who's always in floor length skirts is all of a sudden going to wear a mini skirt. So I think you have to go shopping with your daughter. Try to pick three dresses and then negotiate there. But try not to use the word, oh, that's too sexy, because then she's definitely going to want it.
Talk about dangerous. You don't want to seem like you're too hands-on when it comes to
You want to be her partner, dressing your child.
Right.
I think with dressing, that's the time you want to be her partner and make her feel like, I want you to look the best you possibly can. But also, I think there's another issue when it comes to how much money you're going to spend on this dress. It's one night, and it's not worth spending 6 months' pay on. So go to the stores, try to find something great. I encourage girls to go into their mom's closet, their aunts, their cousins. Find anything you can in an old bridesmaid's dress. You can shorten it, make it look great. But as far as it being too sexy, I mean, that's going to be a battle. It is.
And maybe save a little cash to put in their purse in case they get into trouble, need to get some sort of taxi or car service from,
yes,
you know, from where they are.
And I have a great safety tip for that. You should always carry a pair of flats in your purse. Because, or keep it in the car, because you never know when you get into a situation, you got to take up those high heels. Maybe if you get into a dangerous situation, you need to run. You always want to have those flats with you, and also you're going to get uncomfortable, and you probably
night.
Won't want to,
yeah,
wear 4-inch heels all night.
All right, Erica Katz, thank you so much for
thank
joining
you.
Us. And we hope you all have a healthy prom season. And next, teens lobby in Albany in a stand against cyberbullying, and later, a gospel performance that brings down the house. Stay tuned.